Hello, Andy here, VW Coco. Saturday the 1st of June, and it's engine day. I was going to go at the workshop this morning, work on the Vauxhall Victor, but we was out for the day yesterday up in Bournemouth, about 280 mile round trip, what we done. Totally whacked today, doing it in one day, weren't good. Reason why I went up there, see Simon at NOS VW and go up for the day. More on Simon in a bit. So, the Wizard. Got the 1300 patina bug ready to go in, which you will see in a bit. But in the meantime, I'm gonna start cleaning all the gearbox housing out, the shaft. Renew the fuel filter and lines. Give it a bit of a detail. Maybe today the engine will go in. Oh, you gotta laugh. It's only been 10 months. Right. Right, the hydraulic bug engine. Wiring's all but done. But the other day when I was trying to start it, I thought it was like a little knocking noise underneath. So, reading the valves, and I've never known an engine to have so tight of a valve, no gap. They were C-solid, man. Brought them out to the correct gauge in 0.006 of a mil. Not too bad. But as you can hear now, put it down, you tell me what this noise is. Stay. All right, quick turn over the engine. Ready? I can hear something knocking. I can hear something knocking. Yeah, not only that, the carb flange wasn't even flat. Now, I tapped him down Thursday evening, pulled across the road with the minis, come over and give it another tap, and we got them pretty much flat. But as you can see, this carb won't fit on there. This is the 30 pick. I think I'm going to pull the engine out and put the old Wizard engine in, which I'll show you in a bit. Yeah, stuff it. That's what I'm going to do. That's another engine job. Right. Reason why I went up to see Simon, I picked up my missing chrome trim. This is fitted with the early style. Yeah. I've got to go up workshop, get a couple more clips. Let's see if he starts. I just put the keys in. Code start. This one's ready to go. I've been driving him about. My mate Kev's old one. Alright. Let's see if we can get him going. This has been, well, see the battery, right? 2 weeks. 2 weeks. Got the correct fan belt come. He needs a 890 mil. So the 905 didn't fit. That is sweet as a nut. Absolutely sweet. It's a 1200 engine. Cracking. Cracking Beetle. The pop-outs. See, he's fitted the early chrome trim. Even when at Bournemouth, I've got an haircut. But that's the Mrs. Wizard. Got to wet the engine on the hydraulic. We'll see what's what, whether I can get carbs to fit or, oh, I don't know. Inside, give it a good tidy up. Gotta cover all the wiring up. I've started to crack on. Bit cloudy now, the sun was out. pretty hot. Right, inside. We'll start with the engine that's going in the Wizard. This one came out of the Patina Bug. Ran like a dream. It was rebuilt by Raw Speed. Now, I've just ordered, when he came out, he broke off the dizzy stump. What we got ordered from Simon at Power Spark. 5% discount in the comments. I'll show you what I've created, Mrs. Coco. An old 3-4 distributor. With the coil, it comes to £50. It's points in here, as the reason why I already had a electronic ignition module. I've done that with a trade with some parts, so that saved me £30. So swappy Rooney. And here's the uprated coil. Bams. So I'll fit all this once the engine's inside, but happy days on that. So Simon at NOS VW with a chrome strip. I'll put a link in the description if you need any parts for the T25, bay window, Beetle, etc. Give him a shout. His brother Luke does the engines. He's got the workshop next door. I couldn't film, gutted really, because we was in a rush. The family wanted to go to the local shops in Wimborne. But Simon, class, didn't even charge for the chrome trim. That's the kind of guy he is. And that's what the VW guy should be. Trade here and there. But here's the old Wizard engine. I started to pull him apart Thursday evening. Reason why he came out, he had no tinware. Bent bolt. So, look at the red paint, just like under the bonnet. Everywhere. So I'm putting the oil cooler on with seals, new seals. Whilst we're here, let's have a go. I covered this up, so done a bit of grinding this morning on a new engine bolt, because this side here, it was all rounded off and I had a mare getting them out. So new bolt and down. Let's get some splitty action, eh? Will it run? Well, it ran a week ago when we took him out for the day. All right, Mum. Right. Keys out. Yep. Been a week. Reinsured last month, gone up a few quid, so happy days on that. So that's me today. Oh, this was covered in dust and all sorts, and I bought, where is he? Bought this on Amazon. It's 5 litre, made by Gunk, the Ultra, superb, absolutely superb. But he says he's ready to bolt in. Got to lift him down yet, get him on a trolley. Hopefully today we'll see. If not, be over the weekend. And I'll bring you back when we started getting him inside. So that's that. Yeah, Power Spark, Simon. That's another Simon. 5% discount, superb to deal with. Simon at NOS VW. Give me the trim. Brilliant. Scene down here, yeah, there's a load of crap really. Plymouth scene. Anyway, engine day. When I say about the Plymouth air cool crap, I mean not many cars around. I'm gonna set up a VW Coco meet probably next month now. I've got a Facebook page, VW Coco, if you wanna check it out. But if you're local, give us a shout. Go from there, but let's get the air-cooled scene back on the map, eh? Alright, cleaned up the gearbox housing. starter motor. Just made up a fuel line, but I'll fit this once the engine's in. Take off rear wheel and fit this. These bearings all good. That's looking cracking. Going back to this one, the knocking, it could be Conrod. But like neighbour said, put the other card back on, give it a go, something may free up. Because I don't know when it was last run, like I said before. It could be the engine bolt underneath, not tight. I started to pull it out before I got it, so any one of them reasons is the old carb. Now, before I took it off, or when I took it off, this carb flange here on the manifold wasn't straight. Tapped in there with an hammer, and Paul came over and gave me a little bit more tap down, but he's not sitting, there's a little bit of a gap there, look. So, needs a little bit more work, but before he was, yeah, really bad. So, a few bits to do on this one. Hopefully the engine don't need to come out, but if we have, we've got the 1600 inside. Let's get this in, so not too concerned. Right, so that's the wizard done for the day. What the plans are, I'm going to get the splitty out and put the wizard in the garage tomorrow and do the engine in there. A lot better, I've got a lift. So, easy to get out the tools. Makes sense of outside here. This one here. What I found out was this manifold all loose. It's a bolt inside here. Down there was loose. Put the other carb on, so that is rock solid now. I'm going to tinker about, see if I can get this running, see if we can get the noise going. Smack some mystery oil down, is it, with diesel in the UK. Smack that down, see if it'll free up, stop the knocking, go from there. So tinkering about with this the last half hour or so, put the car back on. Yeah, I wonder if they knew it was a problem, they started dismantling it. Side manifold bolts all tight, this one here was loose. With a new car, maybe they couldn't get it to start. I'll crack on with that. Overall, I had a good day, a lot of compliments on the old wizard there. You know, talk to all the neighbours. So all in all, happy days. Don't look as much done. No, enjoyed it. So what I've got to do now is pack up, run down the shop and get Mrs. a big, massive bouquet of flowers because there's no engine in. Anyway, thanks for watching. Part two, tomorrow or the next day. All right. Cheers.